Have you ever wondered how life was during the medieval times? How they built such magnificent structures without modern technology? Indeed, the medieval period, spanning from the 5th to the 15th centuries, was an era of extraordinary architectural accomplishments. It was a time when human ingenuity, creativity, and craftsmanship came together to construct some of the most awe-inspiring structures that still stand today, defying the ravages of time and weather. These historical sites serve as living textbooks, offering us invaluable insights into the past. They tell tales of kings and queens, battles and truces, love and betrayal. They bear witness to the rise and fall of great civilizations, each leaving their unique imprint on these structures. In our quest to uncover these stories, we've carefully selected 10 sites based on their historical significance, architectural grandeur, and the intriguing tales they hold within their walls. Join us as we embark on a journey through time, exploring the 10 most beautiful medieval sites in the world. We begin our journey in England at the imposing Tower of London. This historic castle, nestled on the north bank of the River Thames, is a symbol of royalty, power, and intrigue. Built by William the Conqueror in the late 11th century, the tower's architectural grandeur is as arresting as its rich history. The White Tower, its central structure, is a perfect example of Norman military architecture. Its walls whisper stories of kings, queens, and infamous prisoners, adding a touch of mystery to its allure. The tower has also served as a treasury, an armory, and even a menagerie at different times in history. Perhaps the most captivating allure of the Tower of London is its collection of tales and legends. From the haunting myth of the Ravens of the Tower to the tragic tale of Anne Boleyn, each story adds a layer to the tapestry of its history. The Tower of London stands as a testament to England's rich and tumultuous history. Next, we travel to France, to the ethereal Mont Saint-Michel. This medieval masterpiece, perched on a rocky islet amidst vast sandbanks, is a wonder to behold. Mont Saint-Michel dates back to the 8th century and was initially a place of pilgrimage. Over the centuries, it grew into a strategic fortification and later a place of scholarly learning. The brilliance of the architecture is evident in its gravity-defying design. The abbey at the peak of the mount was an incredible feat of medieval engineering. Its construction required immense ingenuity to adapt the buildings to the rocky terrain, with structures ascending in the form of a pyramid. The uniqueness of Mont Saint-Michel also lies in its location. It's surrounded by the sea during high tide and reveals expansive sandbanks during low tide. This ever-changing landscape has earned it the nickname, the Marvel of the West. Mont Saint-Michel is a marvel of medieval architecture, rising majestically from the sea. We now journey to Spain, to the magnificent Alhambra. Perched atop the Darro Valley, this fortress palace complex whispers tales of the Nasrid sultans who once called it home. The Alhambra, or the Red One, was a stronghold of the last Muslim emirate in the Iberian Peninsula, flourishing under the reign of the Nasrid dynasty in the 13th to 15th centuries. Its architectural grandeur is a testament to the genius of Moorish artistry. Endless arabesques, calligraphic inscriptions, and geometric patterns adorn the walls, each a tale of devotion and skill. The Court of the Lions, with its famous marble fountain, is a masterpiece of symmetry and balance, a symbol of an earthly paradise. The Alhambra's gardens, the general life, are a verdant oasis where sultans would escape the politics of the court. Here, amidst the rustling leaves and the gentle murmur of running water, one can almost hear the echoes of the past. The Alhambra, with its intricate designs and stunning vistas, is a jewel of medieval architecture. Our next stop is Italy, home to the awe-inspiring Colosseum. This colossal structure, standing tall since the 1st century AD, is a testament to the architectural prowess of the ancient Romans. Imagine, if you will, a time when this grand amphitheater, capable of seating over 50,000 spectators, echoed with the roars of the crowd and the clashing of gladiator swords. The Colosseum, originally known as the Flavian Amphitheater, was more than just a venue for public spectacles. It was a symbol of the Roman Empire's might, a manifestation of its grandeur. Every stone, every arch, tells a story of a civilization that once ruled the world. Despite the ravages of time and man, the Colosseum still stands, a silent sentinel to Rome's glorious past. From its bloody gladiatorial contests to the dramatic naval battles, the Colosseum has seen it all. Today, it continues to captivate the world with its haunting beauty and its enduring strength. The Colosseum remains a symbol of the grandeur and might of the Roman Empire. We now head east to Russia, to the iconic Kremlin. This fortified complex at the heart of Moscow is not just a feast for the eyes, but also a treasure trove of history and culture. The Kremlin has stood the test of time, witnessing the rise and fall of empires, the revolutions, and the transformations that shaped Russia. The Kremlin's architectural style is a reflection of its rich past. Its walls and towers are a blend of Byzantine and traditional Russian styles, while the colorful domes of its cathedrals are a nod to the Italian Renaissance. Throughout its history, the Kremlin has been a seat of power. From the Grand Dukes in the 15th century to the Russian presidents of today, the Kremlin has seen it all. Its role in Russian history is unparalleled, making it a must-visit destination for any travel enthusiast. The Kremlin, with its colorful domes and imposing walls, is a symbol of Russia's power and history. Our journey now takes us to China, to the majestic Great Wall. This colossal monument, an architectural marvel, has stood the test of time, snaking across the vast Chinese landscape. The Great Wall's history is as long and winding as the structure itself. It began as separate walls built by individual states 2,000 years before Christ. It wasn't until the Qin Dynasty, in the 3rd century BC, that these walls were connected, creating what we know today as the Great Wall of China. Stretching over 13,000 miles, this immense structure is an enduring symbol of China's historical strength and resilience. More than just a wall, it is a testament to human ingenuity and the sheer determination of a civilization that dared to build such an ambitious defense against invaders. The Great Wall of China is a testament to human ingenuity and determination. We now travel to Cambodia, to the mesmerizing Angkor Wat. Emerging from the jungle's embrace, Angkor Wat remains a testament to the might of the Khmer Empire. This vast temple complex was built in the 12th century by King Suryavarman II, an ambitious ruler who sought to immortalize his reign in stone. Angkor Wat, originally dedicated to the Hindu deity Vishnu, was later converted into a Buddhist temple, illustrating the religious evolution of the Khmer Empire. The architectural style of Angkor Wat is a marvel to behold. It showcases the classical Khmer style, known as Angkor Wat style. This is characterized by its grand scale, symmetry, and the extensive use of bas-reliefs and devatas, or divine guardians. The stories of the Khmer Empire are etched into the walls of Angkor Wat, offering a fascinating glimpse into Cambodia's past. The intricate carvings depict epic battles, celestial dancers, and everyday life scenes. Angkor Wat, with its intricate carvings and grand scale, is a marvel of medieval architecture. Next, we journey to Peru, to the mysterious Machu Picchu. Nestled high in the Andes, this fascinating city is a testament to the architectural prowess of the Inca Empire. Built in the 15th century, Machu Picchu showcases the Inca's sophisticated stonework, a marvel that stands undeterred by the passage of time. This city was once bustling with life, but it was abruptly abandoned, leaving behind a mystery that has intrigued historians for centuries. Some theories suggest a devastating epidemic, others speculate about an internal conflict, yet the truth remains elusive. Despite its abandonment, the site was never truly lost. The local Quechua people knew of its existence, and in the early 20th century, it was brought to international attention by the American historian Hiram Bingham. Today, Machu Picchu stands as a symbol of resilience and ingenuity. It's a place where history whispers through the winds and every stone tells a story. Machu Picchu remains one of the world's most intriguing and beautiful medieval sites. We now travel to Egypt, to the timeless pyramids of Giza. These iconic structures are the last of the seven wonders of the ancient world still standing, a testament to the architectural prowess of the ancient Egyptians. Constructed around 4,500 years ago, these pyramids served as the final resting places for pharaohs, the god kings of Egypt. The largest of the pyramids, the Great Pyramid, was built for Pharaoh Khufu. It's an engineering marvel, built with over 2 million stone blocks, each weighing an average of 2.5 tons. The pyramids are shrouded in mystery and lore, with tales of hidden chambers, ancient curses, and celestial alignments. The pharaohs who commissioned them aimed to showcase their divine power and ensure their immortality. The pyramids of Giza, with their imposing size, precision, and the enigma that surrounds them, continue to captivate us with their mystery and grandeur. Finally, we arrive in Greece to the magnificent Parthenon. Perched atop the Acropolis, the Parthenon has been watching over Athens for over 2,000 years. Built during the Golden Age of Athens in the 5th century BC, this temple was dedicated to Athena, the city's patron goddess. The Parthenon's architectural style is Doric, the simplest of the three classical Greek architectural styles. Yet, the beauty lies in its simplicity. The Parthenon is a marvel of design, featuring 8 columns at the ends and 17 on the sides, creating a harmonious balance of proportions. The Parthenon played a central role in ancient Greece. It not only served as a religious center, but also housed the city's treasury. Despite the ravages of time, wars, and vandalism, the Parthenon still stands, albeit in ruins, a testament to the indomitable spirit of the ancient Greeks. The Parthenon stands as a symbol of the ancient world's architectural prowess and a testament to human creativity. We have now visited the 10 most beautiful medieval sites around the world. From the robust Tower of London, standing tall in England, to the mystical Mont Saint-Michel, rising from the tides in France, we've ventured through the intricate designs of Spain's Alhambra and witnessed the grandeur of Italy's Colosseum. The Kremlin's imposing presence in Russia led us to the vast stretches of the Great Wall in China and the ancient temples of Angkor Wat in Cambodia. We then scaled the heights of Peru's Machu Picchu, marveled at the pyramids of Giza in Egypt, and finally basked in the glory of Greece's Parthenon. Each of these sites holds a unique story, a testament to the civilizations that built them, the people who lived there, and the events that shaped our world. They are windows into our past, offering insights into human ingenuity, perseverance, and the relentless pursuit of excellence. These sites remind us of our past and inspire us to build a better future. They are not just structures of stone and brick, but symbols of human achievement and resilience. Thank you for joining us on this journey through time.